Today I'm going to show you lots of positive information about the COVID vaccines, so you certainly can't accuse me of spreading misinformation, unless you're accusing the Immunisation Coalition of lying. This is the Immunisation Coalition's homepage, a website in Australia. They advocate for immunisation across the lifespan. The Immunisation Coalition have recently updated their COVID risk calculator, which is what we'll be looking at today. But before we get started, I'd just like to mention our sponsors. Well, not my sponsors, but the Coalition's sponsors. To see their sponsors, click on the menu icon, click on About, then click on About Us. We are the leading voice in whole-of-life immunisation in Australia. And as you can see in the photograph, everybody is very happy that they've been immunised. Against everything, I assume. Scroll down, you'll see the Coalition board and staff members. They seem to be a bit lacking in diversity. They should probably do something about that. Right down the bottom, you'll find their sponsors and supporters. You know, household names like Moderna, Novavax, Pfizer. The point is, you can trust this data that I'm going to show you today because it's supported by the biggest names in the industry. Head back to the homepage. To access the risk calculator, click on COVID-19, then click on Risk Calculator. Coracle is a tool to help people make decisions about getting a COVID-19 vaccine. It shows how the vaccine can lower the chance of catching, getting sick from, or dying from COVID-19. It also shows the chance of getting rare side effects from the vaccines. Sounds great, doesn't it? Scroll down and you'll see that there are actually three calculators, one for Pfizer, one for AstraZeneca, and one for Pfizer for children. For example, let's use the Pfizer calculator. I'll fill out the details with my information. So 43-year-old male, vaccine. I assume we've all had our recommended number of doses of vaccine, but just for the purposes of this video, let's pretend we've had none. How many cases are there in your community? Well, who would know? Nobody's getting tested anymore. So let's just stick with the default of 5% chance of getting COVID over 2 months. Click the terms and conditions and then calculate risk. Scroll down to what is my chance of dying from inflammation of my heart muscle, myocarditis. According to the data, my chance of dying from myocarditis after the first shot is 0.0033 out of a million. If you click on the number, it says 0.0033 cases per million people. This is the same as 1 in 300 million chance. 1 in 300 million? According to Google, in the United States, the lifetime odds of being struck by lightning are about 1 in 15,000. So that means that by the time you die from myocarditis from a single shot of Pfizer, on average, you'll have been struck by lightning 19,607 times, according to the Immunisation Coalition. Okay, perhaps I'm not comparing apples with apples. To be fair, the chances of being struck by lightning in any given year is 1 in 1.2 million. Assuming you only take a single Pfizer shot per year, and this 1 in 300 million chance holds true, then this would still equate to being struck by lightning 250 times before myocarditis takes you out, at least according to the Immunisation Coalition's calculator. It should be noted that this is the increased chance of dying from myocarditis. According to the same chart, my base risk of dying from myocarditis, even if I haven't had any vaccine or any COVID, is 1 in 750,000. That means there's 400 times more chance of me dying from random everyday myocarditis than there is from taking the Pfizer vaccine. And I suppose it comes as no surprise to most of you that COVID infection is the primary cause of myocarditis, killing 1 in 2,300 people. This means that COVID myocarditis kills 130,434 times more people than does the vaccine, according to this trustworthy and reliable data. The calculator also shows that my chances of catching COVID are significantly reduced after 2 months of having a second shot of the Pfizer vaccine at 1 in 44. This is compared to a 1 in 20 chance of getting COVID if I am not vaccinated. Also, it shows my chances of dying from COVID are significantly reduced with a second shot of the vaccine taken 2 months ago at 1 in 21,000 compared to 1 in 5,400 without a vaccine, so about 4 times the risk of death according to this chart. Anyway, what this all goes to show you is that the Pfizer vaccine is truly a medical wonder and an amazing product. By the way, did I mention our sponsors yet? Pfizer! Back to our risk calculators, it should be noted that the calculator we just looked at hasn't been updated for over a year, so perhaps the data is a little bit dated. The most recently updated calculator, however, updated 27th of February 2023, so only a couple of weeks ago, is the Pfizer for Children calculator. Let's take a look at that and find out the results for a 5-year-old girl. So what is my child's chance of having inflammation of their heart muscle myocarditis? According to this chart, it's less than 0.0001 out of a million. And in case you don't understand what that means, they've explicitly stated extremely rare. If you click on it, they don't even give you the odds because it's so infinitesimally rare. But I calculated it myself, just for your benefit. It's one in a gazillion. Catching COVID is at least a million times worse in terms of myocarditis for your young daughters, according to this official and therefore accurate data, with a 1 in 12,000 risk of COVID-induced heart inflammation. In terms of chances of getting COVID, 2 shots of the vaccine offers a small reduction in risk. The vaccine also reduces the chances of getting multi-system inflammatory syndrome due to COVID by about 80%, and reduces the chances of the child going to hospital by about 2/3. Lastly, let's take a look at the third calculator, just for completeness, the AstraZeneca calculator, noting that it was only updated about a year ago. I'll just go with the same setting, 43-year-old male, no vaccine. What's my chances of getting rare blood clots? Well, for the vaccine, it's 1 in 50,000, and I guess unsurprisingly to most of you, rare blood clots are a lot less rare when you catch COVID, at 1 in every 2,000. So there's 25 times more chance of getting rare blood clots from COVID infection than there is from the AstraZeneca vaccine. Another amazing product. Finally, I'd just like to thank our sponsors for all their wonderful support and funding. Without them, especially Pfizer, we couldn't have made these accurate and reliable calculators that show you beyond a reasonable doubt that the vaccine is safe and effective, and I think that I've proven in this video, safer than lightning.